I'm working on transition of blending this dye into my furnishings. I don't like to have extremely short hair and then all of a sudden furnishings. I like it to be a smooth transition so it looks like it naturally grows that way. And, you know, for those people who are watching, they notice that I brought hair back, took my tip off, or just that ridge line, brushed it back down again. If it looked like it still had a ridge, then I brushed everything back up again, took off my ridge line, brushed it forward again, and just repeated that process over and over and over until it gets, so it just looks like it naturally blends into that. I don't want people to be able to tell where the short hair ends and the long hair starts. I want a smooth transition.
And is that, is the purpose of that to make it not look like there's furnishings there, but that's leg?
Yeah, it should look like it's part of the leg. It shouldn't look like it's just fringe on there. One of the things that stuck out the most that I was taught was don't leave hair just to leave hair. The people that, when I've judged grooming competitions, have found I'm a very stickler to, and very adamant about smooth transitions. I hate seeing hula skirts. I want it to look like it should be naturally growing that way. And so if you're ever in a grooming competition and I'm judging you and you got a hula skirt there, you're not going to win.
Well, the purpose of grooming is to accentuate
right.
the quality of the dog and kind of hide the problems on the dog. And the way you do that is not by just dangling hair in a particular spot, because that draws actual attention to the problem.
Right.
You want to disguise the problem.